I'm Dave McHugh for D3Football.com, and this is my D3 report from Mustang Stadium on the campus of Stevenson University in Owings Mills, Maryland, where it was homecoming for two very good running offenses. Wilkes coming in top in the MAC conference in team running, and Stevenson coming in number three in the conference in rushing as a team, and having the best rushing running back in K.K. Smith in the conference. And running would certainly get a lot of play in this game, but it was also miscues that took place. Stevenson actually punted on its first possession, but got the ball back thanks to a muffed return. Getting it at the 20, and two plays later, Kasparovic was able to find Jeremy Miller 17 yards, and Stevenson was up 7-0 early. But Wilkes would respond on their very next possession. 9-play, 75-yard drive culminated with a Tyler Bernstein to Justin Pulaski 19-yard touchdown play, tying the game at 7, and that really would be the theme of this, Stevenson scoring and Wilkes responding. The two teams would combine for 28 points in the first quarter, 14-14. Second quarter, relatively quiet compared to the whole rest of the game. No scoring would take place until the very last play of the game, when K.K. Smith would follow a monster jumbo look off the left-hand side for his first touchdown, his second touchdown of the game, ended an 11-play, 96-yard drive for the Mustangs and put them up 21-14 just at the halftime. Starting the second half, though, Wilkes would respond. They would score a tying touchdown thanks to Patrick Ngully, which would actually start and be part of a Smith to Ngully back and forth touchdown barrage. The two would combine for 5 touchdowns in a span of the third quarter and the beginning of the fourth, culminating with K.K. Smith with another 2-yard run to put Stevenson up 35-28. It would be Smith's fourth touchdown of the game. But Wilkes would once again respond. This time, a 12-play, 89-yard drive, finishing with Bernstein to Curry for 21 yards in the back of the end zone, tying the game at 35 apiece. Stevenson would get good field position off of a return, but were unable to do anything with it. Would give the ball back to Wilkes, who would then go down the field in 18 plays, 90 yards, to set up a 20-yard field goal with 11 seconds left. Frito hitting that and giving Wilkes its first lead of the game at 38-35. 11 seconds left. Stevenson would get the ball on the kickoff, get the ball to the 30 with 8 seconds left, and would try and run their hook and ladder play that they actually succeeded in scoring a touchdown late in the game against Lebanon Valley. But this time, the second pitch going to K.K. Smith, he dropped the ball. Wilkes would recover the fumble with no time on the clock. So Stevenson loses a heartbreaker at home on homecoming. 38-35. For your stats, Wilkes had 531 yards of offense, 337 of them on the ground, while Stevenson had 326 yards of offense with 210 in the air and 116 on the ground. For Wilkes, they were led by Patrick Ngully. 30 carries, 210 yards of rushing, 2 touchdowns. Tyler Bernstein, the quarterback, 24 carries for 114 yards. He would also go 12 for 21 in the air, 194 yards, 3 touchdowns, and an interception. The leading receiver, Dan Curry, 3 catches, 60 yards and a touchdown. Pulaski had 2 catches, 54 yards and a touchdown. For Stevenson, K.K. Smith led the team with 25 carries, but only 96 total yards on the ground, the first time he has been held below 100 all season by any team, including the MAC, but he had 4 touchdowns. Kasparovic would throw 19 for 31, no interceptions, 206 yards, and 1 touchdown. Jeremy Miller, 6 catches, 93 yards, a touchdown. Max Wilson, 3 catches, 25. And K.K. Smith would also have 3 catches and 18 yards, so over 100 yards of total offense. For Wilkes, they improved to 4-3 overall, 3-3 in the conference. They will travel to top-running Lycoming next week, whereas Stevenson falls in heartbreaking fashion once again to 1-6 overall, 1-5 in the conference. They will travel to Kings next week before they will take on Lycoming on the road the following week. So another tough loss for Stevenson here on homecoming, certainly an emotional one for the Mustangs and for Wilkes. A good game for them as they continue to try and strive to be above 500 this season. I'm Dave McHugh. This has been my D3 report, and I hope to see it on D3Football.com.